the cases on these things are just huge. It's like you could live in it. Uh-oh. Maybe I shouldn't have done that. I don't want Spider-Man to fall out on the floor here. Something fell out on the floor. Let's get it on the bench before I make a fool of myself. It's that good old evaluation thing again. And looking for things we don't like. So the first thing we don't like is that. That shouldn't look like that. And once again, I don't know, pick up height, tough to say unless I fret the last note. Let's look how warped the neck is on this guy. This one's not bad. Oh, by the way, I'm hooked on that Celestial Seasoning Holy Thunder Black Death Tea or whatever the hell it is. I'm so energized, I've bent over backwards and tied my own nuts in a knot. Okay, the neck doesn't look too bad, but we'll tune it up to pitch and get this, see what's going on with the spring thing in the back. Yeah, it's some sort of new tuning. What the hell? Reject. Like I said, maybe I can actually make it do what I said it'll do. Hold on. So what'll happen when the strings, when the springs are like that, and when you pull up on the trim, the center spring is really slacks off compared to the other two, and it can pop out. I can almost lift that out with my finger, so, and I didn't pull it backwards very much. This is loads of fun with the reverse backwards upside down headstock. I'm not, you know, dyslexic enough. They throw that one at me just as, you know, for a curveball. What the hell is this thing called? The performer. The reformer. I guess if you're just out of jail and Spider-Man caught you, I have no idea. Holy smokes, there's a letter from, there's a message in a bottle here. I hope, does that say angels or angles? Love you as much as we do. This is for you, Taz. How cute. No idea what they're talking about. As usual, the frets are all tarnishy and the fretboard's all dried out, so let's fix that first. And let's fix that first. The love letter touches my heart. Maybe they'll see this video, the people that wrote that to each other. We got in the end and managed to check that the truss rod worked. Clean up the frets and the fretboard. This has got the different sort of string apparatus where they fit through these tubes and come out through, so you don't have to lose all those little bits anymore. That's kind of interesting. So I guess I'll string it up and see what happens. Okay, new strings are on it. I got to block it up and tune it to pitch. Stand by. Everything's looking nice and level. I'm gonna check the string action again. Check the intonation. Stretch the strings. Lock her down. Once again, always a good idea to get these little tuners sort of 50-50 before we lock everything down, so you got some movement there in the tuning range. Somebody was saying that, I got to do the pickup height on this. This isn't right either. And, I don't know, let's look down the neck one more time. With all the strings in the way, see what we can see. It's tough to do with this camera because it's got only a viewer, not a viewfinder. That's interesting. Oh, and I didn't show off my belated Christmas package. So cool. It's like a Fender holiday musical ornament for your Christmas tree. Big old red Fender bowl. That's from my buddy Jeff. On the other side, it's got like Santa playing a Telecaster or something. Actually, Santa plays bass. I think that's what's going on there. I think Santa's on bass. Looks like he's playing a P bass. Nope, I think it's got 6 strings. It's like Planet Fender. We're coming in on the ship towards Planet Fender. So I'm doing the intonation stuff here. Meanwhile, attempting to clean up my bench. That doesn't belong out there. And, one more check on the string height at the 12th fret. This one's easy to work on. It's got its own built-in stand. And what I see is very, very acceptable. I'm loving it. 60 thou, 65 thou, around 464s. Very nice. And we'll check the trebly side as well, just because I can and I like to. And to me, it's looking a little high on the treble side, so we might want to adjust that a little bit. Let's pause and do that. I guess I need like a special right angle plug for working on these guitars, because every time you want to flip the guitar up to look at it this way or do any measurements or put it up in the playable position, I gotta unplug the stupid thing. It's an ass pain. But hey, not bad for a home job, for a home paint job. They didn't do too bad. Almost looks like that's brushed on too, so that's pretty cool. I guess they did it for Kara. So I did the old relief measurement thing, and we're sitting at 12, 13 thou at the 7th fret. I'm not going to touch that. We need to correct this pickup height, stretch the strings, lock down the other end, try and get that truss rod cover back on. See, the other bitch is you cannot get to that truss rod nut, so you got to loosen strings again, so you can't have these on. We can have them on, but you can't have them doing anything. And you need to take them off to get the string out of the way. So someone was ragging on to me about, you know, it's just a lot of little fiddly bits on these that just require fiddling. And if you own one, you should learn to fiddle on your own. That's my story. I'm sticking to it. Okay, there'll be a little more. I just got to think of what it's going to be. Then I'm wondering why it keeps changing and keeps changing. 2 stripped out neck screws. That's not supposed to happen. It should eventually stop turning. Gooched again! Okay, so I'm gonna try and get this camera thing so you can see right down the neck. And hopefully you can notice it's got a slight amount of curve in this area. And really, on a guitar, it's almost like you've got 2 guitar necks. And where the relief is, that's where the other neck starts and the other one ends, and allows you to let the strings wiggle when you strum. That's what the relief thing's all about. They need room to wiggle. I'd be happy with that setup. That's like shredder. Cool. Still gonna lock down the other end, but I'll do a little whacking and stretching. Did I say that out loud? Not that kind of whacking. Will this thing pan out anymore? No, I don't have the wide lens. Get this on here. Just break it all in. Break a string before I give it back to the guy. Well, See, like I said, you can't plug it in and like work on it. And thanks to everybody once again. I just looked at my channel and I realized I've cracked 4,000 subscribers. How the hell did that happen? Uh-oh, danger warning, Will Robinson. There it is, the Jackson Performer. It performs. I'm so energized, I've bent over backwards and tied my own nuts in a knot.